let's look at the, you as a guy who has grown up in this place, you definitely have seen people get jobs in this place, people work through, and some people being successful, while others, you know, have still remained unemployed up to now. Let's look at the levels of unemployment in this area. If you were to break it down for us, how much does a common Banda guy survive on, or how much does a common Banda guy make a day?
Yeah, because they are Banda, we have two groups of people in Banda now. We have those who have gone to school and they've studied. We have those that have known, middle, like senior 4, senior 2 there. And we have those that have not gone to school completely. Now, you find that those who are in middle class there, they survive on border borders. They majorly out of riding border borders. Yeah. And you find that many, those who have gone to school, for example, university level, are not employed. They are looking for survival. They hence now, I've seen others joining the border job.
Straight from university. Yes. The just guy gets a border and starts riding.
Yeah.
And that's not what you envisage as a guy going to university. You don't want to be on a border really.
Like I was explaining to you about their levels now. Now it's like the border riding is becoming a gazetted job in Banda, because most of them you cannot move 500 meters and you fail to find the border stage. That means border stages are all over Banda. It's becoming one of the activity that people can do to get money.
I understand that. Let's look at, on a scale of 1 to 10, if you're looking at the unemployment levels in this place, where can you put the levels? How many people are employed out of 10? And who are those that are not employed?
Most of these youth now have devoted into thieves. Others form up groups. Others are turning into music. They call themselves Rastas.
What does the police do? Isn't the police doing its job, keeping its people in Banda safe?
Yeah, I guess they do their work, but again, there are many channels. I mean, they use. For example, there is the NCDC, National Curriculum Department route. Okay. There's that route from that gate down to the
Oh yes.
Yeah. So they use that very route. You find that they snatch their bags from that route.
Christopher, I mean, I understand you're a community worker, a real Banda guy, you know, born and raised. Now you've become something in Banda, a very important person in Banda. I've been walking through the other lower side. Is it Banda 3?
Yeah.
The Kasenyi side, just below the road.
Yeah.
My God, it doesn't smell well. What is the problem here?
Yeah, actually our sanitation in Banda is not all that good, more especially that area. You find that it is that's why they call it Kasenyi, and it is not easy for people there to dig, for example, a pit latrine. Okay. Because of the water that is coming down, and there is that big channel called Kawoya Channel which crosses that area.
Yes.
You find that people they don't have places where to go, as in toilets.
There is the Banda that you want, the kind of Banda you want to see. What is that Banda you want to see?
Yeah, the Banda I would love to see now, because we are growing. I would see a Banda where people are employed.
Yeah.
First of all, people have good sanitation. People have public toilets within the area.
Thank you very much, Chris. I'm really happy I talked to you, and thank you so much for shedding some light about Banda. This is what we do. We go to different neighborhoods and check them out in depth. This is The Hood. Make sure you catch us every 7 p.m. every Saturday here at Urban TV, and we'll try to make your hood a better place. Let's go for a very short break, and we'll be shortly back. DJ K.
Welcome to my hood. Where the hood at? Where the hood at?
Hey guys, welcome back. We are here in Banda, and what we are trying to do is make sure that this place becomes a better place, and people have their own problems that need definitely to be addressed. And I can promise you, before this show ends, we're going to look for a leader in this place who's going to really, we're going to put them up to game. We have to put them on the game, and we have to roast them, and they make sure that they explain the situation that is going here with the locals. How are you, sir?
I'm okay, sir.
You're good. What is your name?
My name is Mulasa Solomon.
Solomon.
Yeah.
Solomon, what do you do in Banda?
Actually, I'm a leader. I'm a youth leader.
You're a youth leader?
Yeah, in my village.
On your village?
Yeah.
So you're like, you represent youth?
I represent youth.
Okay. What are the biggest problems the youth face in Banda?
Actually, the biggest problem youth face in Banda, many youth are jobless.
They're jobless?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What causes that? Why aren't they working?
I guess what causes that, those leaders who are on top of us, they don't give us chance.
What do you mean they don't give you chance?
They don't give us chance for us to work in places, because we all put our application and just dumped aside.
Hey, you're saying that the people who are in bigger offices, they don't see you as very important?
Yeah.
That's but what kind of area or community doesn't appreciate young people? I don't understand.
I guess maybe I would say that they are selfish. They wish for themselves, for them to have something more than others.
What else would you want to address now that you probably have the chance right now? Just say you're talking to the MP of this area, or the leader, and a big leader in this place. What would you want them to hear from you?
Like I said, those leaders, they should see us like, because some of us, though we don't have jobs, but at least we can make some groups and they rob for us.
Yes. Thank you very much, Solomon. Guys, we're still trying to get more of Banda and to know what is really happening here on the ground. As we get to go to the leader who's going to actually address these things, let's go for a very short break. This is Ace Hood, and welcome to my hood. Let's get it. We'll be right back.
I'm talking strip clubs, I'm talking liquor stores. We throwing money around here, but y'all can call it blow.
I'm on probation, so my nerves bad. And they say time flies, but mine's first class. I landed in the sky, I fell from the streets. I talk a lot of and practice what I preach. Back from hell, cell 23. Tell a warden, kiss my pockets on Monique. Bitch, I'm from the murder capital. Ho, I'm far from practical. Shit happens, and since I'm the shit, I'm who it happened to. Young money, cash money, blood, bitch, I'm red hot. I don't see nobody like a headshot. All that bullshit is for the birds. Throw some bread out. Got it sewed up. Check the thread count. Welcome.